seen the birthday bonanza, Kairn, yeah?
Yes, I have. So,
and you saw when I got a wee bit upset about one of Grant McIver's questions because he had the wrong answer.
It rightfully so.
Yeah, yeah.
You should have been upset.
I'd done my research. Mm-hmm. I remembered on the day that the correct answer to that question, the question was like, name two the latest wrestler to have wrestled at two matches on the same Mania card.
Yes.
Right? So I said, well, it's Drew McIntyre on WrestleMania 40 because
mm-hmm.
he beat Seth Rollins and then he got cashed in on.
Yes.
By Priest. But Grant McIver said that the answer was Daniel Bryan back at WrestleMania 30. And I was raging at this because it wasn't true. Because somebody got a point for it as well. I think it was Brody Adler who was just begging for points all night.
As long as it wasn't Tom. That's the main thing.
She was begging for points all night. But there we go. We'll let it slide, Brody. But anyway, so I've found out more.
Mm-hmm.
So Seth Rollins had two matches on WrestleMania 31 because mm-hmm. he wrestled Randy Orton. And then he wrestled in the main event. Drew McIntyre again technically had two matches on WrestleMania 36. Because remember, he beat Brock. And then they had that dark main event with Big Show. That's a good pub quiz yes. question. What was the yes. real main event of the COVID Mania?
Do you think Grant McIver just wrote this after WrestleMania 30 and then never went back to
wrestling ended at WrestleMania 30?
Yeah.
And also Pat McAfee had two matches on WrestleMania 38.
Did he?
Because he wrestled Austin Theory and then wrestled Vince McMahon.
So he did.
Yeah.
Can we mention that?
Well, it's a stat. It's fact.
Well, okay.
But anyway,
it's in the history books, as they say.
That's true. But at least it won.
Yeah.
Hi, so welcome back to the FCW podcast. Bit of a different one this month.
Yes.
We thought let's have a wee catch up almost.
A wee reflection after maybe the past month.
Things have been a bit mad, to say the least.
Yeah, yeah. It's good to have you back after going to get your eye sorted.
Thank you for saving me.
Yes, you're
from
welcome.
From the jackals of Redgate.
Yes, yes. We'll get into talking about them later, I think.
Got me.
Oh! How are we doing? What are you voting?
What are you doing? No, that was
what's
last
that? What's that doing there?
That's a tortoise. What are you doing here? Did you lock the front door, Kairn?
Yeah, give me a vote, pal.
You came here to vote, right? You're a week late.
How did you get in this house?
Yeah, JD, why are you in my house?
Who are you?
And you know me, I'm Patryk Poteski.
Alright, thanks.
This is Kairn Douglas, this is the FCW podcast.
Nice to meet you, pal.
Good to see you.
Aye.
You don't look like you know much.
No.
Kairn, do you want to sit down? You want a cup of tea?
Geezer. Where's the kettle?
Right. Oh, don't you... Oh, yeah,
cup of tea, mate.
We'll go and get that in a minute.
What's that?
I mean...
This is a comfy chair, this part.
Thanks. Yeah,
nobody even
here. Well, I was just about to say we weren't going to have a guest this month.
Yeah. Things have
taken a... Literally, JD Wilde has wandered into my house because you forgot to lock the front door when you came in.
No, I didn't lock the front door.
Okay. Well...
Which makes it even weirder.
Have I got a broken window somewhere? How did you get in here?
They have nice shoes downstairs.
Aye. Jesus.
Right, okay.
Okay, well, this is happening. Sorry, this is a bit taken aback here, because... So what were we talking about? Yes, we were talking about the fact that we've had a bit of a month.
We've had a bit of a month.
Aye, me too, lads.
Yeah.
Have you? What's been happening?
Fuck yeah, you know what? Yeah, go on, JD, tell us. What's been up?
It's up and down and round and round. It's been wild.
Yeah.
Seen some stuff that didn't really need to see.
Yeah.
Seen some stuff didn't really want to see.
Like what?
Well, you ever been to the ferry at 2 a.m?
Aye, well, yeah, I'm usually coming home at that time, but...
Aye, well, I advise you not go in the water. There's some big fish in there.
So you've been back in. Now, I've been meaning to ask you about this, but you always wander off every time I go anywhere near you.
Yeah.
And you go near anyone else. In fact, you were found... Craig, it must be nearly a year ago now.
Who?
You.
Who's you?
You. We're not doing this.
Jacob, yes. This is you. Jacob?
Apparently.
Yeah, apparently.
You got a mirror.
Yeah. You got extradited from Redgate.
Yep.
And then you were found on Broughty Ferry Beach.
You washed up on the shore.
Naked. And then you were just sauntering about. And you've been kind of sauntering about ever since.
You know,
like, do you have any memory of what happened? How you ended up there?
No, I mind waking up and just seeing the sun and just I just follow my instincts everywhere I go, and it just takes us to places that I kind of recall sometimes, but sometimes I'm not so sure, if you care what I'm saying, lads.
Yeah.
I'll agree to move this conversation on.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Feel free to chip in, you know, when you want to.
Aye, sound lads.
Yeah.
I guess, anyway.
So, sorry, just taking a wee bit
back here. Yeah, well, let's get back on track here. So, Aye, well, like I said, we'll go into a bit about what we've been doing.
Yes. Later. It's actually quite good, JD's here. Maybe we can get some insights from
him. Yeah, we might get some inside knowledge if we can, you know,
if we can
winkle it out of him, you know.
Clear the fog.
Aye, that's it. So, well, we'll talk about. we've got a lot of shows coming up, Kairn.
We do. We've got a very busy July.
I'll let you run through it. You run through what we've got and what we're going to go into.
Okay, so should I just go from the start then?
Go for it, yeah. Go for the first show. What are we going first?
First show, we've got July 19th in Perth. We have FCW there, which we'll run through the card there as we have that.
Making our return to the Empire Zone.
Yep, that's right.
Like biscuits.
Yes, JD, you like biscuits.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
You want an Empire biscuit?
I do want an Empire biscuit.
Do you prefer an Empire biscuit or a snowball?
There was nothing in your bench.
Well, it was bin day this morning, was it?
I forgot to put my bin out.
Yeah. Nah, biscuit would be good.
Yeah. We'll get that with your cup of tea in a bit. We usually have a wee break. We'll do a wee tea break in a bit.
Then the following night, on the 20th, at the Queen's Hotel, we have the DAPW.
You nearly said.
I know, that. I nearly crumbled.
Became one of them. DAPW on the 20th at Queen's. Yep. So that's a really
good weekend. Go for that. And then the following weekend, we have on July the 27th, we are back in Tayport.
Oh, I can't wait.
We don't have much really on that, so we'll just discuss the bits we do know.
Yeah.
And then for the following day after that.
Right. And you're going to pronounce this perfectly first time, I believe. On
July.
Yeah, July 28th.
Yes.
Right. Where is the show?
I pronounced it right. July.
Yeah, July. No, the location of the show. Yeah, the town. What town are we in?
Freakham?
Yes!
There we go.
He's been practicing this all day.
I know. I didn't want to get it wrong. But yeah, that's a wee charity event we've got. We'll probably talk about that a bit later. Just right at the end, probably, as well. But yeah, so.
You got the card up, or do you want me to hit it with the first match?
I have it up as well. Right. It's up to you to.
Right, I'll pick a match first.
Yes, okay.
Because this is a very interesting one. It's a rematch from last year, I believe. I can't remember exactly when last year, but it's for the Junior Heavyweight Championship, and we've got a very different Spike Tierney to the one that was around this time last year, taking on the returning Solar to FCW.
Yes. Very, very changed Spike we've seen, haven't we? Things have took a wee turn that we didn't expect a few months ago.
But he's still, I mean, we've talked to death about that, but he's still the guy that's defending his championship at every opportunity.
That's true.
And, I mean, Solar might have almost preferred Spike to have still been the way he was before, because he would have had a lot more prep to go on. Like he would have known what kind of Spike Tierney he might have been in for. Yes, he would be able to strategize a bit differently. But
that strategy may be out the window now, I think.
Different Spike now, so it makes it a very, what was already an exciting matchup anyway. It's put that different twist on it, so it'll be interesting to see how Spike and Solar get on this time.
Yeah, well, he's a wee Torag, and he might be good at jumping a bit, but his time's going to come.
Which one?
What?
Which
one? I think he means Spike.
Aye, the flippy end.
Has he got like a boot in the arse with his name on it?
Aye, I think a few of them have
Good.
Aye.
You just going to show up?
I might.
That's kind of his thing, isn't it? No. He's established that, just wandering the podcast.
Depends what the food's like on the night, usually.
What do you normally get in catering, like?
Just whatever. Just left on the plates or that.
Just leavies.
What do you mean left on the plates? Well, like on people's plates that
are. Well, you shop a boot, do you, when you go in? You just see what's about.
You're minesweeping people's plates backstage.
You done with that, cheers. No, I'm not.
Got some good pairs in that, eh?
Get a good pie at St Johnson, by the way. Just down the road from the talk, actually.
Oh, really?
It's one of my favourite pies in Scottish football. But anyway, I won't get sidetracked with that too much.
It's not the pie podcast.
It's not the pie podcast. That's different. That's a different podcast. right, Kairn, you go for it. Pick another match from Empire. What was sent it?
So, we have a good tag match. It is a title match, isn't it?
It is.
We have,
this is the open challenge you're talking about.
I think so. We have the returning Retro Filth, the tag champs.
This is kind of what they do now.
Yeah, I think it's an open challenge, isn't it? They've just
Again.
Yep, the same as last month. We don't know who's going to show up. Maybe it's JD Wilde. Who knows? Could it be?
Well, I don't know.
If you wander in at the right time, you might get attacked.
Well, you never know, but I couldn't say I agree with some of the stuff they boys do. It's a bit of.
Would that not have flown back in your day?
No, I've done probably worse, to be honest. But aye, can't be doing that, eh? Can't be doing that sort of thing.
Like, the sort of open challenges, or like the what they get on
up to what they got up to inside the ring, it's a bit.
I suppose he's not in a tag team anyway, so I highly doubt.
I could do the both of them.
Okay.
He did used to be in a tag team with a man who we're going to talk about later on, but I don't know if he remembers it.
No.
We might bring that up later when we speak up.
But so Retro Filth, they're enjoying this, aren't they?
Come at us, come at us hard. Yeah. And then we'll see who turns up.
Yeah.
That's what they say in the promos.
Yeah.
Get your mind out of the gutter, honestly.
Met Ryan?
I have, yeah. Do you think he's thinking about that offer we made him back in Queens?
I think he's still maybe
because he's still got the hat. And I saw a photo of him recently. Splicey, I'll put this in
because
I'm editing it now because Andy the Johnny wasn't cutting it anymore.
No, he gave up. There's
a lovely wee photo of Ryan Rude wearing a Kairn Douglas headband.
I know, I've heard about that as well. I need to see this.
Dude, maybe lift that off the next table, eh? Cheeky sausage, Ryan.
Maybe you left a fiver, I can't mind.
Yeah. Check your chains.
I need to check my chains.
Where'd that fiver come from? But we had Samuel and Valak answer it last month.
Mm-hmm.
Came up a bit short.
Yep.
But we'll talk about them later that night as well, because we're a bit busy with them. So, it's open to anyone, isn't it?
Anyone could come
in. Any two people in FCW could show up and challenge for the titles, and who knows?
We're a bit occupied, that's what I was just about to say. If we weren't occupied that night...
If it was another month, JD, maybe we would have been right in there.
But would we go after our dads like that?
Could we fight with dads?
Could we fight? We could battle our dads.
I don't hear dad.
You must do. Everyone's got a dad.
No.
You've came from somewhere.
Aye. I have.
Maybe JD's actually just the second coming of Christ and he doesn't have a father. It was like a miracle birth. Could that be what it was?
Well, it's Star Wars.
Yeah. Are you Jesus?
I
remember you were hallucinating a while ago and you saw Hunter Redwood as Jesus.
I did see that.
Yeah.
The picture of Hunter was just helping you off the street.
Yeah, mind when you went off your bike.
That was Jesus.
Okay.
That was Jesus.
Right. We need to tell Hunter that he's actually Jesus. He could start his own church. He could hold ceremonies every week and JD would just turn up.
And one of them big pastors and just...
No, I'm not really a God-loving guy, I've never...
What about a God-fearing guy?
A Hunter-fearing guy.
Yeah. Not really that either. I don't care what he turned up for. I think he's wanting some money.
Sounds about right. The way he was chucking the wallet around in Wembley Stadium, he's probably still paying that off.
He didn't care, did he?
I know. Right, I'll go next.
Yes.
Get things back on track again. Another match we've got coming up that night is Lou King Sharp versus Duke.
Yes.
The one and only Duke, because he keeps referring to himself now. Part of that Packer. Or maybe they don't even have a name, do they?
I don't know what they're called.
I don't really know what they're called either, but I mean, again, without wanting to tread over old ground, we know what my history is with Duke.
Mm-hmm.
I'll never discount how good he is in the ring. But one thing we do have to bring up is this group and the fact that they've been getting up to no good in and out the ring. Tom Atlas, I know he's not involved in this match, but he cost Lou the Junior Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah, recently. I think Lou had a good chance of securing that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And obviously Tom's injured right now, so Lou knows that he can't go after Tom.
Yep.
So he's thinking, well, what's maybe the next best thing? It's to go after Duke.
Yep.
Because he can actually get in the ring with him.
And he knows Spike's occupied.
Yeah, he knows Spike's match occupied. That night, so why not take on Duke?
Yeah.
Take your anger out on Duke.
Yep.
And I think if Tom's sensible, he should probably stay away from things like that, because when Lou King Sharp's angry, it's not good for anyone who's in his way.
No, you feel the wrath. Yeah. It's very, I think it's quite smart thinking, Philu. You know, to say, up there for thinking, down there for dancing. I think he's got it.
Yeah.
I think he's eyed this one up pretty well.
Duke does obviously have the numbers advantage. Even with an injured Tom, it's still somebody that can... I mean, we saw what he did to Yuji Maki with his crutches a few weeks ago at the last show.
Nasty bit of stuff, though.
Not nice from a young upstanding member of the Perth community, Tom Atlas.
Yeah.
But Lou's more than capable of picking up a win there, but again, as always with these guys, you've just got to watch the numbers again.
Yeah, it's very unpredictable.
Right. I'm going to leave our chat to last on the show.
Discuss that. So we'll leave.
Right, now, you've got your cup of tea now. You happy?
Right, I'm happy.
Yeah, I didn't have any Empire biscuits, so I'm afraid. So you need to do it for a wee
pro- just think about the Roman Empire.
Yeah.
There's a hair in this.
Ah, that'll be the cat.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Yep, so he's apologising. Sorry, no. Yeah.
They eat you in China.
He's looking at you like we eat you in the wild.
Maybe a bit bigger than you, pal.
So the next match is Noel versus JD Wilde. No, the next match we're going to talk about is for the it's going to be for the FCW Heavyweight Championship.
Ooh.
We've got the newly dubbed or self-dubbed, in fact, I'm going to call him it as well because I think he deserves it. The Giant Killer.
I think we coined this phrase actually a podcast or two ago.
Dickie Divers, man, he's been running through all the big boys. I mean, look at the men that he's been taking on in the last few months. The likes of, well,
Caleb
Valhalla,
Liston Ross,
and now he's got Hunter Sampson.
He's a big boy.
Yeah, he's one of the biggest boys in the whole of Scotland. The hardest man in Fife as well, as we know. I think this is just Diver's thing now. He's wanting to prove that, the bigger they are, the better it is for him. You know, he's just going to, you're going to doubt me every month. I can take on these massive men, guys that are maybe, you know, even a foot taller than him. But the thing that Divers has got on his side in this match is the experience. Divers has been doing this for a long time. He knows every trick in the book. He knows how to defend championships against men that are bigger than him. So
you've also got Serena being a factor as well.
Yeah.
She appears to be doubling down on helping him. So
you know, it's like losing her championships just fueled.
Yeah.
Probably not just Divers, but Serena as well. To think, right, we've lost one of the.
We're not losing the other.
We've lost one of these top championships. We need to make sure we hang on to the other one.
Which respect, loyalty.
Well, yes, you got to stand by your man, as they say.
No, it was fair to put the title on the line against me. Because I was awfully close, I think.
You were very close to that. I remember that. Because I remember, we were a bit confused on commentary. We were like, is this for the championship? Is this not? And I remember thinking, imagine if... Because even if you had beat him that night, you would definitely have been in line for a championship match. But
I mean, when?
You'd literally just spoke about it.
Did I?
Yeah, you did that.
Okay.
Oh, well. Just you drink your tea.
Alright.
But yeah, let's see if he can slay the giant of Fife.
Yes.
Yeah. Right, we need to get on to our match that night.
Well, we've still got... Well, right, okay.
What have we missed? I don't even miss them. Divers and Hunter, got that. Looking Sharp and Duke, got that. Retro Felf, got that. Oh, no, you're right, sorry. I missed one. There was one sneaking in there. Well, we'll leave us till last, because we'll naturally probably talk about it a bit more, because we're involved in it.
Yeah.
Now, this one, I was away for this on show, obviously, last time, but when I got back from my surgery in Germany and saw the footage, I recoiled in horror at what Holden had done to Bochico, and his behaviour since then has been uncouth, shall we say, at the very least, is probably putting it politely.
Yeah.
He's just been making fun of the fact that he nearly ended Bochico's career with Holden.
Folded him into an accordion.
Aye.
He's lucky to be walking away after
Bochico that. Bochico's very lucky to be walking after that match, but thankfully...
But I think it's set a fire.
He's back in the ring, three, 4 weeks later?
I think it's set a fire under him, and he's not letting either of them get away with this.
No, I think the big boys should just stick to ploughing the fields, you know? Chucking hay, but...
They're not that big.
Oh, no. Right.
That's all I'm saying.
Are you going to explain that? You know what I'm saying?
No, we'll just... He gets it.
Last month we had Bochico taken on Holden. This month he's taken on the other half of the Prophets of Doom, Solomon Grum. Been informed as well that if Bochico wins this match, he gets to pick a tag team partner for a match against the Prophets of Doom the next day on the Queen's Tell Show on July 20th.
However, if Grum wins, Grum gets to choose his partner for that tag match.
If Solomon Grum wins, he gets to pick Bochico's tag partner. And and Holden was also going to be banned from ringside because of those... horrible things he's been saying about Bochico and making fun of Bochico that match. So we're going to get a fair fight.
Yeah.
I mean, obvious speculation is who do you think Bochico would pick, who do you think Grum would pick, but probably the best way to find out is to show up to both shows and then find out what's going to happen the next night.
I think they'll both pick JD.
Aye, well, they could either do that or...
Who'd you rather wrestle with? Would you rather wrestle with Bochico or would you rather...
Stone Cold.
Okay, yeah.
Steve Audrey.
Yeah. Oh, was he on the camp shows, on the...
Aye.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
On the tribute shows.
Back in the day.
Yeah.
He'd run through anybody and everybody. A big lad. Another big lad. I reminisce the days. I'd sit at the beach. feed each another pineapple chunks over a bottle of wine now.
Good times.
Good times. Don't call Steve Audrey. Anyway, aye.
Aye, so. You alright?
Aye.
We'll talk about how much then.
Aye. Yeah. So. I'll let you start.
Yeah. So, yes, as we all. If you don't know, if you don't know about what's been going on with Not Safe for Mums and Redgate, now, where have you been living for the past couple of months in the FCW universe, for lack of a better term? So we stopped Redgate from essentially going 4-on-1 against Emily Hayden a couple of months ago, because that's not on.
No.
We got on well with Emily as well, so we didn't want to see our pal get beaten up.
Mm-hmm.
Tommy Cross didn't take this very well. Him and Samuel jumped me at the training school a few days later.
Yep.
Got a nice bit of black mist in my face, which I've still got my patch on for, but I'm hoping it's going to be cleared up by the match, but we'll just need to wait and see. The fact that I'm getting to wrestle the match is a bonus in itself. Kairn came and found me after getting chucked in the woods somewhere in Dundee. You got sent me off to get patched up.
That was a long trek to find you, by the way. That was no. Just they hid you well, by the way.
I'm glad you thought it was worth it.
Yeah.
I know a very nice group of people.
No.
You would know firsthand, wouldn't you?
I get what you mean. I can't recall much, mate.
Yeah.
Just remember seeing red all the time. Everything was red.
I think that's what Johnny sees.
He's an angry boy.
He is an angry boy.
But yeah, I mean, like, he's had it in for us ever since then. And I said it in a call-out video for them. You took him to the absolute limit in that strat. And the fact that you had the balls to call them out in that, I think you called the bluff a wee bit. I don't think they expected that.
I didn't think so. And I think it forced Tommy to come out. He's been hiding for a while.
Mm.
And forced him.
That's the thing. What's he been doing? But
I don't know.
Maybe
trying to change since he's... not the JD remembers, but
since he's done a number on JD.
That's Patchy boys, it's Patchy. I remember my pals. Don't remember much else, just red. Can I remember a dodgy knee? Some fingernails.
It did a number on my nail, by the way. It's still healing. That was Valak, man.
Yeah.
That was his party piece. A week of torture from then.
Yeah.
You finding them, and then you torturing Tommy, and Tommy torturing you, and that's how is your back, by the way?
Aye, you're doing well.
It's alright. It's some bruises still, couple of marks, but I'm sure over time we'll heal. But it's not stopped us.
And we thought, right, how do we up the ante even more from calling them out for a strap match? What are they not going to expect? Let's call out the whole lot of them.
Yeah.
Because it's been all four of them right from the start that have been involved in this. It's not just been one or two or three,
but as I said, they've just been pushing and pushing, and they do it with everyone.
Yeah,
and I'm sick of it.
It's about time somebody's
aye.
Stood up.
It's about time. Like,
aye.
I know he was a bit of an instigator before when he was in them, but look what they've done to him now.
Aye.
That wasn't him that done that.
You don't remember, like, having a go at Ethan and then Tommy and Samuel jumping you.
Darkness, mate.
Kerrigan choke slamming you at hell, and then. You don't even remember that, and then you just wake up in the ferry. Like, this is how much of a number, because I want to know what they've done in between, but, like, obviously nobody's going to know, because they're not going to tell us.
No.
Like, it's really concerning, like...
It's a long road back for me, boys. All I see is darkness and pain.
Do you feel better than you did when you first kind of woke up from all this? Like, how's the last few months been for you? Like,
brah. I went to Seaton Sands. Picnicking down in Butlins, it was great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, quite a bit like, yeah. I'm eating a lot now.
Good. That's a good sign.
Seen less red?
No red anymore. Yeah,
that's
good. Look at a bit of red wine, you can.
Yeah, that's alright, that's
it. Well, we're going to find at the bottom of the bins, really, yeah. Waitrose is good because you get all the broken bottles at the back, so you could just poke a hole and then fill a cup, it's good for that.
I swear Waitrose is in, like, Edinburgh in Scotland. So you've been all the way there. How far do you walk?
It's quite a bit. I've been through four pairs of sandals, two pairs of trainers, and one pair of Skechers that I found at the side of a house.
I think you should invest in Crocs.
Aye.
I think that would
be breathable footwear.
Aye.
It's the way forward, it's the future. It's the future of wrestling.
We'll look forward to seeing that in a match near you soon. JD Wilde wearing Crocs.
But yeah, did we finish explaining what the match?
Yeah, I mean, like, yeah, we've caught them out. Yeah, how do we raise the ante?
Yeah,
call all four of them out, and then no rules. Only that,
then hire a truck and run them over.
He's cracked it.
Well, maybe a bit too far, but
mate, after all they've done to us,
I don't think vehicle manslaughter is maybe the.
Ah, but it's a wrestling match. It's fine. But yeah, in all seriousness, yeah, we thought, how do we surprise them again?
Yeah.
Let's call all four of them out. No rules, no disqualifications, anything goes, tornado tag, all that.
Yeah.
And I can't wait to battle them.
Yeah.
And they're going to get what's coming for them.
Get my hands back on Tommy, I can't wait to get
them. I've been waiting for months to get my hands on Samuel and Valak and Tommy and Eden, because she's complicit in this as well.
Yeah. They're a bunch of ghoulie bams, aren't they? Like. Yeah. Fed up with her nonsense.
Yeah.
Aye, well, he's could count me in if he's won a hand, because Emmy was up for smashing some goffs.
We'll give you the secret signal. Yeah.
Aye, what's that?
Oh, we'll show you later.
Aye.
Don't worry.
Do I give it there?
That's no sexual thing, is it?
Oh no. We're not actually retro filth. Okay.
Alright, well, yeah. What's this?
That's Flash, the tortoise.
All right.
The fastest tortoise alive.
Yeah.
Aye. Yeah. That's nicer.
You'll not go in your tea, don't worry.
No.
The cat will though.
No.
But that is July 20th.
Yeah.
And you can get your tickets as always.
That's the 19th.
On faircitywrestling.com.
Patryk, that's the 19th.
Well, it's 19th, sorry. 19th.
The 19th.
Retcon.
In Tulloch.
Yeah, it's the 19th in Tulloch. Tickets at FCW.com. FCW.co.uk. Can I remember?
Ticketsource.co.uk.
Yes, ticketsource.co.uk/FCW.
Now, July 20th.
Yeah, I'm just excited to talk. And even though I'm not even going to be there, I'll get that out of the way first. Mm. Again, I announced on my page recently that for a number of reasons, one of them which, because I'm still recovering from my operation, I pretty much know that I'm not going to be cleared to wrestle on both shows.
Mm.
And I am more than willing to put our fight against Redgate ahead of my King of the Class crown. Yeah. Because we need to do what needs to be done.
Yeah, we need to end this with them. That's the priority.
And my conscience isn't clear for what happened at the last Queen's show, because I got too distracted with what was going on with me and Duke at the time. I should have been defending my crown that night in some form of King of the Class match. So, because I was given those opportunities. Mm. I was given the opportunity this time last year in the Battle Royal at the time, which I won. And then I defended it in the Rumble it was January. But then I met you, mm-hmm. and we'd been getting pally that night. Yep. You ended up helping me in that Rumble to win that. Then you helped me against Richmond at the end there. So then the things change. Mm-hmm. Like, priorities change sometimes. Not that I don't think this is an important accolade. It is. It's like, it's partly what's made me who I am so far in my wrestling career. But what I think's good about it is it gives people opportunities. Gives mm-hmm. people opportunities to go out there and wrestle for something that hopefully means something. I've tried to make this mean as much as I can. And I think the honourable thing to do and the right thing to do is step aside, abdicate, and let somebody else win that King of the Class Rumble match and hopefully go forward and defend it with pride like I've done for the last year. And the thing is, Kairn,
well,
I will be back one day to reclaim my crown.
Well, I'm going to announce it now. I'm putting myself in the King of Class Rumble.
You're declaring.
I'm declaring
live. I'm going on into the podcast. That Rumble,
and I'm going to win that crown, and I'm going to bring it back to NSFM. It's staying in the team.
Could I go in it?
Aye! Yeah!
Well, come on, let's be kings of
class. You'd be a class king.
I probably would. Yeah. I would be a class king.
What was your favourite class at school?
Eh?
What was your favourite class? No, you didn't go to school, no.
I don't think he knows what you're talking about.
Yeah.
You can't remember anything past 5 minutes ago.
Techie?
That was techie.
Bit of woodwork?
Ah, disco teching.
Ah, yeah.
Aye.
Yeah. Double disco tech on a Friday.
Aye.
The bibliotech?
Raves. And dance. Let's get this on. Party time in the place.
That's Spanish for library. Yes, yeah. I know languages.
But yeah. Auf Wiedersehen,
goodbye. But that is the King of the Class Rumble.
Yes.
That is back.
Yes.
And I hope, Kairn, that you can keep it in the family. Keep it in
I'm bringing it back. I'm declaring it now.
You're bringing it back.
I believe you'll be doing double duty that night then, yeah?
I will now that I've put myself in the King of Class Rumble. So yeah, I will be. I have Mr. Sean Fagan.
Mm-hmm.
I've never met him before. I've never had a match with him. I've seen a couple of his matches.
Yeah. Last time I remember him at the SCW was in the Fair City Rumble last year.
I was injured at that point, so I wasn't there. But I have seen some some of his work. He looks quite good. But it'd be a good challenge.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to a wee fresh challenge. That's what it's all
about, challenging yourself.
Because the whole plan is, we hopefully, we get rid of the red gate,
mm-hmm.
we clean that slate, that's the hopeful, and I can go in here fresh, hoping no interference, no nothing, and we can just have a nice clean match. Yeah. That's my hope for this.
Do the wrestling.
Yes. Do the wrestling.
Do the wrestling.
I'm on the wrestling.
Trying to look what else we've got here. Well, we talked earlier on about Bochco and his mystery partner that'll either be decided by himself or by Solomon Grum. They're taking on the Prophets of Doom.
Even the sides match.
I mean, it goes without saying that, you know, if Bochco wins and he gets to pick his partner, he's going to pick who he thinks best complements him and his style and who could combat the Prophets of Doom as well. But you kind of touched on it earlier on, like if Solomon Grum wins, like assumedly he's going to try and like saddle Bochco with somebody who he thinks is going to be easy pickings for the Prophets of Doom.
I mean, they could pick Rich Money. Because you know he'll do anything for a payday.
He will.
And so he would just go and just ruin it for Bochco.
Yeah.
So that's something.
You could imagine Rich just like going down the line in the middle.
He would screw Bochco over. Just to screw Bochco over. He 100% would.
Yeah, he might want something.
Yeah.
But
then who do you think? Who could Bochco? Who would he?
I mean,
as I say, you need someone just about the same size as him, so then they're evenly matched.
And you would think, like, we know who Bochco's pally with, but a lot of them are busy that night, yourself included, so... And if you're already in two matches, then, you know, like,
three's
a bit of a stretch. But again, like I said earlier on, turn up on July 19th, turn up on July 20th, and you'll find it. That's probably the easiest way to find it. We can sit here and speculate all night.
Yeah.
But we'll not do that, because we've got things to do. Like talk about UNG Market.
Yeah, he's just, I don't know what he's got.
We're dishing out the surprises a lot recently. I like it.
It's announced, so it's not.
Well, I mean, we don't know who he's facing, though.
Oh, yeah.
So it could be
what he's doing, isn't it?
Well, it will be, the official line is, UNG Market is in action.
Right.
The colour is here now.
Currently green and black.
Still green and black.
Yeah.
Sound.
What colour do you remember you and us?
It's like a butterfly, is he?
Yeah.
He was changing his colours, that lad.
Mega Market, all the colours in the room.
And that ring that could fly. Aye.
This has been wild, man. Ah, I didn't even mean that. Yeah. That was a good pun. Anyway, right, where are we? So, main event time on this show.
Yes.
J Robin is putting his Dundee and Angus Pro Wrestling title on the line against the tactician Taylor White. What are you saying to this, Ken?
Taylor White's a good challenge.
Yeah.
He could easily win and take that title away.
The tactician's not just a moniker, it is who he is.
He could use his maths to win, is that what that means?
That's it. Remember all those really
uses equations and trying to figure out and work out distances as he does these.
Remember all those really boring equations you used to have to do and the teacher would say, you'll need this one day.
What's that teacher?
Trying to think. What's a teacher in JD language? Probably can't say that on the podcast. Taylor does what Taylor does. He studies up. He's had time to prepare for this match. He'll have been looking at every single main event that J Robin's been in recently. J's been kind of taking that spotlight and running with it. So this is his latest challenge. See if he can defend his title.
Yeah.
He's been defending his title a lot more often than what he should be.
Yeah.
In terms of what should be the rules of the DAPW Championship. But I kind of rate it, I'm not going to lie.
Like, he does what he wants. He has been on a wee bit of a tear. He's had some imposing challenges that he has overcome.
Yeah, and this is the latest one.
Yeah, well, he hasn't overcome it yet.
Well, that's true. The latest one he needs to overcome, that's what I meant, sorry. So we'll need to see what
happens. Yeah, we'll need to see how that goes.
And the shows keep coming thick and fast, Mr. Douglas.
God, I know.
Because a week after that, we do have Tapot on July 7th. We're back in the Larick Centre. It's been a while, but I'm looking forward to it. Right, you got another cup of tea. You happy now? There's no cat here in that one.
Aye, I'll do.
Are you happy with your Empire Biscuit? I had to run into the shop and come back.
No, didn't the jelly bit on the top must have fell off.
Did you eat the jelly bit?
No, there's jelly there. You've seen what they come like for the shops. There's hardly any on it. Yeah. Don't give me any of that crap. Aye. Eat your biscuit.
Cheers. Well, this wouldn't happen back west, would it?
What's
that? I told you, it's a Tall Toys.
Oh, yeah.
Just saying hello.
Okay.
We're getting there, kid. We're getting there.
Okay.
I still want to know how you got in the house. Anyway, July 27th.
Yes.
We're back at the Larick Centre on Tapot. It's been a while. I'm glad we're going back. Because I love it in Taipo.
Yeah, so it's a good crowd, obviously.
It's a good crowd. It's a wee town that means a lot to me. I used to go there a lot when I was younger. Car boot sales and all that. Nice days out.
Mwanda Booty.
Yeah, Mwanda Booty.
Mwanda Booty.
We walked in the harbour. We went for a nice wee walk doing your dog, I remember, a few months ago.
Aye, we did. Yeah, we did. Yeah, nice we gandered down.
So I'm glad to be back there for FCW.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know too much about the card so far as we record the podcast. The one thing that has been announced... is Rich Money
and the great return
returning
of the infamous Ian Ambrose.
Can't wait for that,
man. Oh, it's gonna be brilliant.
It's been a while. Was it last November that he was taken out by Dickie Divers in that that ladder match.
Mm-hmm.
So it just shows you how badly he was roughed up that night by Dickie Divers.
Yep.
But yeah, so like the fact that Ian's been out that long just shows you like how much he was destroyed that night.
And
he's gonna have Dickie Divers in his thoughts. That's good. Definitely, he's called already. That's going to be his ultimate goal, is to try and come back and win his heavyweight championship. Of course, whether Divers is the champion before Ian gets back to the title picture, that's a different thing. But you do know that he's going to be wanting to get some measure of revenge at Divers at some point. But Rich Money's called him out. It's a bold strategy, Kairn. Let's see how it pays off.
Things haven't been going well for Tories recently.
And Rich calling Ian out in his homeland of Fife as well to make his return match. I don't know how wise it is, but
I feel familiar face that lad. Yeah.
Now
who Ian?
Remember, JD. Remember. It's in there somewhere.
Was this land before time?
Remember who you are.
Okay.
You'll remember one day.
He will remember.
Remember. You just drink the tea, remember.
Remember? No, not remember.
That's a whole other kettle of fish, Anyway, right. So, yeah, we talked about it before.
Mm.
Tayport's a great wee community.
Yep.
We do know that. The Larrick have been great to us over the years as
well.
We did a few wee training sessions earlier this year as well, trying to get some of the bairns in Tayport and maybe a bit of interest in wrestling. Mm. I know that the Commissioner, Kevin Williams, and Jay Robin were recently a fun day at the Larrick trying to promote FCW.
Mm.
So, yeah, I mean, it's a venue we want, and it's a venue the wrestlers want to wrestle, and we love wrestling there.
Be good. I'm looking forward to it. I don't know what we've got. The card's still not been announced, I think, because we've got to get through the 19th and the 20th first.
Well, do you know what? I hope we're on it. That's all I'm saying. Because I want a wrestling table, as we all do.
Yeah. Childhood dreams for you. And
but the next day...
Oh, yes.
I think we will be wrestling on that one, because we're on the bloody poster.
We are on the poster.
Spicy the poster in. Yes, look at that. Oh, that's a sexy poster, that.
Man, two boys
there. Oh, NSFM are on the poster for SCW's debut in Freakum, baby. We're doing a lovely charity show.
Yep.
To try and help the hub and freaking basically survive, because it's something that is very important in wee towns across Scotland. There's places like this to try and put stuff on for the community, because places like maybe Freakham or Tayport, for example, there may be towns that didn't get a lot because they're small places that are maybe closer to bigger places like Dundee or Arbroath or wherever that they all maybe get these events. I'm glad that we're going to a place like Freakham and giving the people a bit of entertainment.
It's as William Regal said, he went about when in his younger days and he would go to all these different wee remote places and he said it was the best crowds, best experience he could have got. So it's definitely something, these wee towns are needing it, I think. Yeah. So it'll be good.
And we are now Dundee and Angus Pro Wrestling.
Yep.
So the fact that we're spreading out into Angus as well and getting all these shows, getting all these shows in places like Freakham, it's a good sign.
Hopefully
in the future we can hit other towns in Angus as well, but we'll just need to wait and see. But we've got a lot of things to get.
Got a lot going on just for this month or the next, as you said, couple of weeks. So,
but I think that's pretty much us, isn't it? We've filed through that, but we've got a lot done. We've had a surprise guest.
Yeah.
Right. Any of you going near the bus station?
I was just about to ask how you're getting
about your bus. There's a bus stop down the road. Well, I think we'll wrap things up and then we'll find out how you got in and then we can find out how to get you home. Maybe we'll get Hunter Redwood, Jesus, to come and help you.
I need a new bike.
You need a bike, right. We'll go and get him a bike.
Maybe one of them e-scooters. Mm. I feel like he'd be up for what, riding one of them.
Right. So we'll just get him out of our hair and then we can continue with the Red Gate plan.
Yes,
I have been Patryk Poteski.
I've been Cam Douglas.
This has been JD Wilde. Do you want to plug your socials while you're here, JD?
What's the social?
Exactly. That has been JD Wilde. Thank you very much for listening to the FCW podcast. Yeah. Get your tickets to all of these shows that we've just been talking about on Ticket Source.
Yep, Ticket Source.
And on Fair City Wrestling's website.
Yep.
And aye, we'll see you next time.
See you next time.
All the best.
Ta-ta.